8765432. taste okay, Marie?
Mm-hmm.
It's warm enough.
Very good.
Yes.
Tastes good?
Very good.
Mr. Jenkins, do you want dinner too?
Yes, please. Can I get some SpaghettiOs?
Okay. Marie, is it okay if I prepare Mr. Jenkins' dinner? Can you do this one? Careful, please.
Careful.
Thank you very much.
Hey, Franny, your daughter's here, so you can go on your break now. I'll cover for you.
Oh, okay. Can you feed Mr. Jenkins' dinner?
Yeah.
Ha ha ha!
So fierce. I just had the same conversation with my parents before they left. left. They're like, Tala, don't do this, and Tala, don't do that. And Tala, make sure to brush your teeth. And Tala, don't get pregnant. No, party, party. I so study us that they're such a bore. Their name is Tala, by the way. What's yours?
Gabriella, but you can call me Gabby.
Oh, like from High School Musical? Where's Troy?
I'm totally kidding. So, what are you drinking? Free nursing. What about you?
Well, I wanted to live out my lifelong ambition of being a thriving street artista. Well, my art will be displayed in a very big art museum across the world.
Really?
No, I'm actually going in for nursing. Yeah, so, I mean, we should probably get to study, like, right now.
Yeah! coverage of cops killing people of color was so ubiquitous, it was impossible to ignore. One would think this would be front page news.
Hey, Robert, do you have headphones? Sorry, I got a quiz tomorrow.
Yeah, my bad.
Actually, I needed a break anyway. So, what's going on?
Different day, same injustices.
Oh, I get it. So, you've known Gabby since, like, high school?
I mean, we're neighbors, but never really talked much, you know?
Yeah. So, have you, like, ever, like, liked her or
no.
Oh, okay, so, what you're telling me now is you're single right now.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not for me or anything, but it, you know, could be, but it's not. How's the Kalayaan thing going on?
Oh, yeah, I recently went to a workshop about undocumented Filipinos. Pretty enlightening on the stuff that's around that.
Yeah, not really something you think about when like being undocumented or anything.
That's what I thought.
Yes.
But it's like an issue that's not really talked about. I mean, there's other workshops too, like what's Filipinx?
Yeah.
What's Eurocentric mean?
Big words, big words.
But I mean, you should come through sometime.
Oh, no, I better not. I'm nursing program, so I should probably study.
I mean, there's other things too in the party kind of way.
Oh, I mean like, will you be at this like party?
Yeah, but not with you.
Oh, hey, Gabby, what's going on? I'm just studying for homework. I mean, studying for anatomy. Probably gonna like cry about it later. But
it's college. What do you expect? A walk in the park?
A walk in the park?
I'm not trying to get mad or anything. I know not everyone experiences the same thing in life, but just what if you're scared of being in certain situations because of the color of your skin? No.
Man, Rob, I know that was probably really hard for you to say, but I never hear these issues from someone I actually know, so I really do appreciate it.
Yeah,
I mean, all we really do is just read about it and tweet about it, but I mean, we never really do anything about it.
Nah, I get it, but there's another demonstration in front of the admin building in a few weeks, if you're interested.
Well, you have piqued my interest, Mr. Fitzgerald.
I think I should probably focus on nursing.
It's fine. I mean, if you guys change your minds, just let me know. But I really would appreciate it if you guys came through sometime.
Yeah, I mean, you'll definitely see me there, Robert. No, Gabby, come on, we're
sure?
Doing nursing homework. Get, get.
Tell him! Yeah.
Thank you. I always knew that nursing would be difficult, that it's not for everyone, but maybe it's not for me. Are nights spent locked in my dorm room, studying worth it in the end? But I need to remember my whole family is depending on me. They've sacrificed everything for me and I would be throwing it all away. I'm just not entirely sure if it's what I want to do anymore. But no, Gabby, your whole family's hopes and dreams are riding on you.
Aubrey, you know what? It's okay. I'll be a real woman tomorrow, alright? attack of the clones. Work till we break a back and you hear the crack of the bones. And get by, just to get by, just to get by, just to get by. We commute to computer, spirits take you while your eagles spread rumors. We survive and let us turn to consumers. Just to get by, just to get by, just to get by, just to get by.
And then he breaks free, you know, like a butterfly.
Alright, I think you need some water, right? You go sit over there. Alright, I'll be right back. Hey, I want everyone's attention right now. I want to know who invited this black kid to the party.
Oh, shit.
Do you know them? Whoa. Do you know him? I don't know you. I'm half Filipino too, man. Like, what's the deal here? Oh, you're half Filipino. I don't believe you. You see that? Look at them. Now take a good look at me. They're Filipino. I'm Filipino. You're Itim. Egon. A nigga.
Oh, shit.
So why don't you go back where you came from and get out of here? What are you gonna do, huh? You gonna punch me?
Go knock this one.
Push me right now. Right here.
Go ahead.
Do it.
Go.
Do it.
Hey,
hey, hey! What the
fuck? Hey, man, get out of my house! Hey, party's over.
Everywhere I go, someone always looks at me funny. I can't even go to a party without being called the N-word? What is that bullshit? I go home and I'm referred to as that one like I don't have a fucking name! Not just them, but society too. They don't see how hard I've worked and what I've done. All they see is some black kid or some mixed kid, and it hurts so damn much. Look at me. No one sees me for me.
It's okay.
No one sees me for me. Why can't they see me for me?
And that's why there's an X in Filipinas. You know, I just really want to thank you for coming out and listening to me. You know, I know it might be, you might have some thoughts in your head thinking like, you know, Andre, you're not exactly the most Filipino person out here. And, you know, that may be true. And I realize it might be a little ironic that I'm part Spanish and I'm teaching you about your culture. However, I'm also half Filipino. So I understand what it's like to come from a culture, from one that takes power, and from one that, I wouldn't say relinquishes it, but it's taken from them. And it's important for us to get a common ground and understanding of each other. But I digress. I go on these little tangents. So, let's bring it back. When you hear the word Filipino or Filipina, what do you usually think of?
Magic City!
Well,
what about Bago?
Filipino identity. I wanna know what you see. What you see is that it's more than our food and our beaches and all our outside features. If you can't answer, I'll tell it to you now. It's nursing, let's start conversing of why we choose to force it on our young. It's nursing, let's start conversing. Is this really something you wanna go along?
Same places, same spaces, same place.
Stereotype. Thanks so much.
model minority. The pay is better here now. That's why, you see.
So you're saying nursing isn't something you should try to be?
That's not what I'm trying to say. It's a respected profession. Here is what I'm trying to say. For us, it's identification, like our food and our beaches, and all our outside features. It's another stereotype to be concerned about. It's nursing,
hey.
Start conversing. Is this really something you wanna go along? It's nursing, start conversing. It's never too late for you to turn around.
Same places, same spaces, same places, same spaces.
Yes, it's a stereotype, but if it calls you, then do it. The problem is in the societal pressures to become it. No one should feel the need to be a nurse because of their kin. You should be free to choose whatever you want, in any skin.
Get on your knees. another black kid beating his woman.
Damn!
While we sort this all out. It looks like we're just about done after hearing your friend Gabriella's story.
Okay, but why the hell
did... Stop! Calm down.
Rob's being walked here right now, okay?
Looks like you're free to go.
Thank you.
Just stay out of trouble.
Thank you.
came to pick me up at the station.
I'm just glad that we found out in time to bail you out. I mean, happy you're here, and you're okay.
I just hope none of this ever happens to any one of you.
Yeah, I hope it never happens to me.
What?
Like anything bad will ever happen to you?
No, let's be serious. Right?
I knew you since high school. You never got detention once.
Yeah, well, like, I'm gonna pull you over with that soy milk skin.
You know, she follows the rules so much. She's such a goody two-shoes. Come on, Gabby.
Like, what would you do? Sleep past your bedtime or something?
Dude,
like,
you know she calls her mom if she could go to parties?
Wait,
she dorms here!
Wait, so that's why, okay, because I heard you didn't want to come in.
Right, that's what I was saying.
I'm Gabby, and I need to study.
Hey, Dear diary.
From the dream I sleep, and then it stops.
just out his face, and then I lost it all again. And then I hear the voices of my night and day, and they tell me no. When you know your path to take, and you feel it burning in, it is easy to capture and picture and see your way. That's only if you know.
It's just, I realize I've never asked you this before, but
dream growing up?
Oh, my dream? You see, Bunso, I'll tell you about my dream. Okay, so, I've always wanted to open my own bakery and sell the world's best pandesal. I was thinking of calling it Kuya James. What do you think?
Kuya, I'm serious.
Oh, no, that is serious.
Kuya.
Okay, you got me. Okay, sandali lang, you wait, Bunso. I need to do something real quick.
Yeah.
Okay, Bunso. Well, I never tell anybody this before, but I've always wanted to be a professional musician.
Kuya, you play guitar?
Yeah, Bunso. It has always been one of my hidden talents. But, you know, once you guys have to leave for the Philippines, I had to put my dreams aside. So then, that is why I'm always working so hard at the sari-sari store. I had to find a real job. But, why? What is it? Why do you ask?
It's just I've been feeling a little unmotivated lately.
But, unmotivated? Bakit? Why? How come?
Well, you know I don't want to do nursing anymore. And I want to change my major, but I don't want to disappoint Inayan at that.
I get it. It's the blood, huh?
No, Kuya. Not just that. I miss us all being together.
I miss you too, Bunso. Even your ate misses you. But just remember, take it one day at a time. It'll get better, I promise.
Kuya, I've been dreaming of it getting better for so long. I just want to stop hiding.
My Gabriela, listen, huh? Well, I think that whatever it is you're doing, you should continue to follow through with it. And I know that whatever it is, you'll be able to handle it, okay? Ay, you know what? I just thought of a brilliant idea right now. Okay, Bunso, you take out a piece of paper and a pen, okay?
Okay.
I need you to write something down. Okay, you have it ready?
Yes, Kuya.
Okay. Listen very carefully. Life begins at the end of your comfort zone. Okay, did you get that, Bunso? You say it back to me. Say it back to Kuya.
Life begins at the end of your comfort zone.
Ayan, there you go.
You know what, Kuya, you're right. Ever since I marched for Black and Brown Lives, that's when I felt like my life was really beginning.
Well, Bunso, that sounds really dangerous, but even though there's not much I can do about you doing that, I just want you to be careful and stay safe, okay?
I know, Kuya.
Are you going to tell Inay about this?
I don't know.
Bunso, you have to tell Inay. She's your mother.
I know, but Kuya, you know how she would react.
Shh! Bunso!
Okay.
Well, is there anything else you'd like to tell to Kuya? Any other problems? What's up?
Well, if there was one thing, I just wish we could have these conversations in person.
All in good time, Bunso. Maybe someday.
So
reason.
Oh, okay, so you're going to sacrifice your life fighting for these people who aren't even important to you, and now you want to change your major to write about them?
But if it's what I want to do, Ma.
Gabriella, this is not about what you want to do, you know? This is not even about you. Do you remember who we are doing this for?
How you want me to sacrifice my happiness?
Oh, shit.
Do not dare talk to me about sacrifices. When me and your dad left your brother and sister, Justin, Esmeralda in the Philippines, and you get to be here. What do you have to say? Me and your dad aren't going to watch you waste all of our hard work on a pipe dream.
Pipe dream? Ma, how would you know? Have you ever even dreamed of something before?
I mean, it was my fault.
Abby, she's your mom. I'm pretty sure she just wants to hear from you.
You don't know that. You don't know what our last conversation was like. I mean, what if that was the last time?
Abby, all I know is that she's your mom, and it just takes one phone call. And look, oh, it's calling right now.
Oh, hey, hey, Miss Mangaba.
Tala, Tala. Hey, good luck. I'll save you a plate because you need to eat.
Tala.
Yes, you do.
Gabriella, is that you? Oh my goodness. Why haven't you been answering my phone calls? I've been calling and I thought you would die. You gave me a heart attack.
But I do have to tell you something.
Gabby, did you get pregnant? Is that why you didn't call me?
Mama, I changed my major, okay?
Your major?
Yes, Mom. And I know it's not what you wanted for me, but Nai, I promise I will do whatever it takes for me to see you guys again.
Okay? That's enough. We fought the last time we saw each other. Just forget about what happened, okay?
I want you to know that no matter what it is you want to do, I will support you. You are my daughter. I miss you, Anak. I miss you too, Ma. And that's why I don't know if I can keep doing this.
Keep doing what?
Being away from my family. Ma?
Gabby, I'm still here. Anak, as much as we want you here, we know how successful you can be over there. You just have to do your best, okay? And forget everything I said before, because my only dream as your mom is for you to follow your own dreams. Just do your best, Anak.
Sa buhay ko.
din ay luluhati ka na. Maninindim pagkat sa buhay mo ay may nagmamahal pa rin.
Capitol Hill.
Gabby.
and I know who I am. When you know your patent ache and you feel it burning in, it is easy to capture and picture and see your way. And now I know my way. For so long my future's paved and set for me, but this is my future, my life, my own new way. This mugger bell knows her way. I am finally free. This is who I am. I'm a Filipino woman and fighter, aspiring brighter, and I believe. But I cannot ignore that my family wanted more. But this is my path, my twisted path, but my only path, not my family.
Action for Childhood Arrivals, we stand here together, united with the power to help push Congress to think about what their actions will do to all our community. At this time, we have a very special speaker who will talk about what she has gone through and how the new change will affect her. Please welcome to the stage, Gabriella Vanessa Mangabell.
Hello everyone. My name is Gabriella Mangabell, and I am one of the 11 million people in the United States that are undocumented. Now people tell me I'm just part of a statistic, but I'm more than that. It wasn't my choice to be here in America. You know, it wasn't my choice to be apart from my siblings all these years, but with the sacrifices my parents made for my family, my only dream has been to take care of that family. But then my biggest fear came true. My parents got deported. The two people who were there for me through all the struggles and trials were taken away from me. My story isn't rare. This ban is keeping families like mine apart. This is why we need new legislation to protect our families. We come for a better life, to contribute to society, but to a society that seemingly pushes us away. Some people, like me, didn't make the choice. And just like you, we have dreams too. Whether you dream of becoming a nurse, a writer, a musician, or just being considered equal, you have to start somewhere. And for undocumented families like mine, this is a step to having our dream come true. If you're given the same opportunity as I am today to speak about our story, take it. Because someone wise once told me, life begins at the end of your comfort zone. Thank you.
Hello, Ma. I just spoke at Washington, D.C.
Anna, I'm so proud of you. Washington, D.C. You're like a movie star now, huh?
No, Ma. But I do have to tell you something.
Gabby, you got proposed to?
You're getting married! Everybody!
No! Sharon, speaker, now speak slowly, go.
I am not getting married.
What?
Mama, but listen, okay? I decided to stay. As hard as it is being apart from all of you, I don't want to just throw away all the sacrifices you made for me, for us, and I know that you've raised me well enough so that I could do it on my own.
On her own?
Oh. Hello, Gabby.
Hi, Ate.
I just wanted to say that I'm so proud of you.
I am so proud. You're getting soft, huh?
Are you getting married or not married?
Not married, Dai.
Come on, baby. No, you guys are always crying. I think we should sing a song to raise our spirit.
Okay, Gabby, it's your brother's supposed to sing to you.
Yes, in bunso. To say that